Good morning. Happy Tuesday. Louder, come on. Woo! Welcome to the Year of Providence graduation for Class 21. My name is Cindy Miranda, and I am a proud member of this graduating class. Before we begin, I would like to recognize the public officials who are here with us today. Central Falls Mayor James Diosa, Providence Mayor Jorge Elorza, Rhode Island Secretary of State Nelly Garbea, Attorney General Peter Kilmartin, and Rhode Island Treasurer Seth Magaziner. I would also like to recognize our education partner, the Community College of Rhode Island. Finally, I'd like to recognize all the CEOs and heads of companies here today. Thank you for making Europe a priority. Our graduation wouldn't be possible today without the generous support of our sponsors. Please hold your applause as I thank everyone. First, thank you to our platinum sponsor, IGT, our gold sponsors, CVS Health, Lifespan, Medtronic, our silver sponsors, Amica Insurance, Stop & Shop, Swarovski, and Hasbro. Our bronze sponsors, Alex Anani, Charity by Design, Alliance Security, Beacon Mutual Insurance, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Rhode Island, Care New England, Cox Communications, Gil Bain, Locklord LLP, Navigant Credit Union, Neighborhood Health Plan of Rhode Island, Nortec, Residential Properties, Zymedica, and Bank of America. Please join me in offering them a round of applause. A year ago, 80 eager young adults committed a year of their lives in exchange for uncertain hope for a better and brighter future. Today, I see those same faces who are now confident leaders, advocates, and young professionals. I am proud to see you all here because you made it this far, despite the challenges in your life. A year ago, I would have never imagined myself here, speaking in front of everyone. I bet my classmates never envisioned themselves at this point either. We have all faced obstacles that we thought were insurmountable. My mother passed away in my senior year at Classical High School. My world forever changed. She was my biggest supporter. After that, I needed someone to challenge, guide, and support me like she did. I found that at Year Up. We were all talented and motivated before this program, but we were missing the opportunities and guidance that Europe provided for us. I joined Europe in hopes of giving my two children a better future and for a second chance at a career. My journey was not easy. I wanted to give up, and I was not the only one who felt this way. I am thankful for all the supporters who are in this room who believed in us. Most importantly, their friends and family members who motivated us to start, stood by us every step of the way, and are here celebrating with us today. Now it's our responsibility to pay it forward for the next class and our community. Or in your fashion, lift while we climb. We have to be the role models now. We have a long way to go as a community, but we are the success stories you hear about, and we can inspire others. We are a passionate group of talented individuals who I know are ready to take on this challenge. This may be the end of our one-year journey, but remember, it's only the beginning. We will always be part of the Europe family. There will be difficult days, but remember, you got through this, you can accomplish anything. it brings me great honor to say congratulations, Class 21, we did it! I would now like to welcome our Executive Director, Kathy Doyle, to the stage.
Good morning, and welcome. Thank you, Cindy, for those inspiring remarks. Cindy is a fierce young mom who has worked extremely hard to take advantage of every opportunity that Europe has to offer her. And as a result, as she said, she is building a brighter future for her two children. And she didn't mention this to you, but I will. She's Alliance Security's newest employee. Welcome, Cindy. To all of you, thank you for being here on this momentous occasion, the graduation of Providence's 21st class. Class 21, you're in the house. Stand up and be recognized. Today we also celebrate a historic milestone for Europe Providence. 10 years ago this month, we graduated our very first class. 14 young adults walked across the graduation stage and across the opportunity divide that day. Look how far we've come. Since 2005, Europe Providence has grown. We've expanded in many ways. We continue to be a premier source of diverse talent and motivated talent for companies in this state and beyond. Additionally, since 2005, we've established ourselves as a leader in terms of we've established ourselves as a leader in workforce development outcomes. So let's think about this for a minute. Almost 678 of our alums are 90% employed, earning life-sustaining wages. That is workforce development leadership. And we continue to build upon that excellence. And here's how. How many of you were at the July graduation? Show of hands. Substantial amount of people were here. Well, that graduating class is now 99% employed, earning an average wage of $16.39 an hour. If you think that you can't beat 99%, let's try again. The Hasbro Transforming Talent Interns, who were graduated that same morning, are 100% employed in Europe-related jobs. So how has Europe been successful, and how will we continue to be successful? There are two main reasons. The first, of course, is always our inspiring young adults. And the second reason is all of you, the community here in this room. As a community, we're building a bridge. And whether you're building a bridge across Narragansett Bay or across the opportunity divide, you need a couple of basic elements. The first is a foundation. A foundation that's built long before the bridge can be erected. In our case, that foundation consists of people who are brave enough to commit to bold change. Our founder and CEO, General Chakabian, our original Executive Director, Sarah Enright, Paul Salem, our National Board Chair, and a few other people who ensured that our program got off and running those first couple of years. Jill Holloway, Richard Dubisson, and Joe Gennaro. Thank you for building our foundation. The second really important component. Are the support beams, or the structures on the side of the bridge, also known as anchors? Supporters and anchors, those are good words to describe all of you here in this room today. Your commitment to our young adults and to our mission has made passage across that bridge possible. So whether you are a community partner, a corporate partner, a sponsor, a mentor, a donor, a team member, a board member, a family, a friend, a supporter, whether you have been with us for 10 years or 10 weeks, you are part of that bridge, and we are grateful. So class 21, it's your turn to cross that bridge this morning. You're graduating 64 strong, and many of you have overcome more in this past year than some of us have in a lifetime. We hear you here this morning, and by your presence, we hear you speaking loudly and saying, I'm worth it, I deserve it, I have achieved it. Today, you join a movement of more than 13,000 alums who have changed the way this country looks at entry-level talent. I'd like to quickly share a story about two of those alums, because in their story, you will see your future successes, class 21. Class 1, Obasi Osborne. Obasi was working as a bar hand at the Hot Club before he joined Europe. He interned at Providence Equity Partners and was hired by Providence Equity Partners after graduation. With encouragement from Paul Salem, Obasi went back to school to continue his education. Obasi is now a proud graduate of Brown University, where he works. Where he works as an IT consultant. He's bought a house and a minivan and lives in the suburbs with his partner, raising his 3-year-old son. Again, there are most of you here attending our graduation in July. So let's fast forward to class 20, the last graduating class. Many of you remember Kiana Fretz. As our graduation speaker that morning, she talked about holding her premature son in the palm of her hand. And now she holds a lot more. Kiana, who worked minimum wage jobs before joining Europe, is now a full-time employee at Medtronic in the Ask HR department. She is going back to school to complete her associate's degree, and she is also saving up for an apartment and a new car. Not bad for 6 months out. So class 21, it's your turn. I'm going to share a number with you this morning that is part of your legacy, and this will be the number to beat for all classes to come. This morning, you are crossing the graduation stage. 63% of you are employed in Europe-related jobs. Class 21, that's never been done before. You are now the class to beat. Congratulations. So you started writing your success stories the minute you walked through the Europe door. And we remember that day, and we remember how you shared your hopes and your concerns with all of us. So take a moment now and be proud of what you've overcome with true resiliency and true grit over this past year. Think about it. I'm going to share a couple stories. Shirley. Shirley's a mom of two. And for the last part of her internship, she needed to move to Worcester. She took a bus from Worcester, Mass. To Providence every single day, and then was picked up at the bus station by her colleague, Jean, who went out of his way to get her, so that they could then drive north to Medtronic. It's a 2-hour commute each way, in addition to raising 2 young children. Shirley is here graduating with Jean today. To Major Joseph, Jorge, and Kevin, who had over-hour commutes to their jobs, to their internships, and jobs to rush to afterwards, never complained because they knew that the opportunity was much larger than the commute. Great job. And then the story that could only be described on the Weather Channel in Storm Stories. Aris had a tree fall on his house. He did what he needed to do, and he didn't miss one minute of his internship. Aris is crossing the graduation stage this morning with a job offer in hand. And then there are our young parents. We have Cindy and Debbie and Shirley and Sylvia and Yuseli and Lewis. We know that being a parent is a 24/7 job. And in addition to your internships at ERA, many of you worked a second job on top of that, sometimes never having a day off. When we asked you how you did it, you told us that your children inspired you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you inspire us. Most of you have worked a second job in addition to ERA. I think about Lisette, who worked an overnight job and got up in the morning and went directly to her internship at IGT, ready to go on time. She's graduating today as IGT's newest employee. And Johnny Perez. Well, Johnny didn't work one or two extra jobs during his time at ERA. He worked three. And he is crossing the graduation stage with a job offer in hand this morning. Way to go, Johnny. Some of you have sadly and tragically, unexpectedly lost loved ones this year. And in your grief, you held on to your grit. And you showed up every single day. And you're here this morning as a testament to that. And your loved ones are here with you. Past 22, you've given back. Cindy said, we want to pay it forward. When you went to your internships, you were not only concerned about the value that you wanted to add to your internship teams, you were concerned about blazing the trail for class 22 and ensuring that they could also be successful. Well, guess what, class 21? You did that. Great job. Before closing, I'd like class 21 and everyone here to join me in recognizing the fantastic Providence team. This team's on the ground every single day. Not only do they throw a heck of a graduation, they support our students every step of the way, and I'm so honored to be working with them. Providence team, would you please stand up and be recognized? Many of the hopes that you shared with us in that first week are turning to reality today. Remember three things. One, you have the talent to succeed. Continue to build on it, continue to learn and grow. It will be important. Two, you have the resiliency in you to overcome any challenges. We know the road will not always be easy, but look how far you've come and know how far you can go. If you forget that for one minute, or if you lose your way, you know where to find us. And that's point three. We will always be here for you. Congratulations, class 21. You've earned this day. We're so proud of you. Go change this country. Thank you, and right now, I'd like to introduce to the stage Major Ketterway, a class 21 leader, and Pfizer's newest employee.
Good morning. My name is Major, and I have the honor of introducing our keynote speaker today, Jared Chaktavian, the founder and CEO of ERA. Before I introduce him, I'd like to share a little about myself. I'm 24 years old, and I grew up in Providence. After high school, I attended New England Tech to further my education. And it just wasn't the right time for me to attend college because I didn't have a clue what I wanted to study. I had no idea who I was and what type of passions I had within me. So soon after that, I decided to put my studies on hold to join the United States Marine Corps. and have served honorably now with them for 5 years. When I returned home from my last deployment in Afghanistan, I was ready to continue my education, and that is when I found Year Up. Chances are, if I were to go around the room right now and ask people to describe what Year Up is, the word program would appear often. The thing is, Year Up is much more than just a program. It is a social and economic justice movement. It is one of the most effective, most influential, and most empowering movements of our generation. Whether you're an alumni, student, corporate partner, staff member, mentor, or supervisor, I want to mention how proud I am of each and every one of you for choosing to be a part of this movement today. You have all chosen to be on the right side of history. Joe Tatavian is the man who started this movement. I'd like to share a few things about Gerald that you were not reading the blue books on your table this morning. When I first met Gerald, it was during one of our weekly professional development meetings. Before he started speaking to us, he took the time to go around the room and look into all of our eyes. Gerald does this with every single class that he gets a chance to speak in front of. He does this because he truly believes in the work that he is doing and the potential that's in each and every one of us. If you ever get a chance to have a one-on-one conversation with them, you'll feel the passion behind his words and motives. It is this passion that drives them to continue to push Year Up to reach new heights every single year. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Gerald Tatavian, the leader of Year Up.
After 15 years, I have still not figured out how to speak before Year Up students, not after Year Up students. Some people never learn. Major, first of all, thanks for your service to our country. Appreciate it. And I think I probably can speak on behalf of just about everyone in this room. When we hear the clarity of your voice and the cognizance of the enormity of the movement that you're pushing forward, I think most people in this room said, I feel like I'm in good hands. Right? Did you not feel that? So thank you to everyone here. 600 people, what an amazing group. Unbelievable. It is so wonderful to have you here to celebrate the graduation of our students today. Imagine that, the 10th anniversary, 10 years ago to this month, that first class walked across the stage. Now 1,000 individuals have walked across that stage here in Providence. Right? And Paul used to tell me, "Gee, Gerald, it's a small city. How much can we do?" 1,000 human beings, as taxpayers, mothers, fathers, great husbands, wives, citizens, voters. Think of what that does for community. Right? And you are here to celebrate that success of our wonderful, wonderful graduates. And graduates, we know, your journey has been remarkable. It has taken courage. It has taken commitment to get to this day. And you got here. And we're here because it is your day. You earned this day. You deserve this day. At the same time, we're here not only to celebrate what you have achieved, but to celebrate, Major, what you talked about as well, which is an important idea in this country. And that idea is that talent is distributed evenly across our country, but unfortunately, opportunity is not. And our graduates are manifest of the fact that they are the talent this country needs. They are living proof that if you give someone a God's honest opportunity, that they will take it and cherish it and take the bus for 2 hours from Worcester to be here, to study every day. And that is a humbling reality, people. A humbling reality that we are not in this country giving enough people the opportunities they deserve to be who they want to be and who they deserve to be. And let me tell you, when I look out at this audience, I say, you know what Providence has said? We are going to do better. We, on our watch, are going to say, no, we will create this opportunity for thousands and thousands of young people. And this program is just getting started. That's why we're here today as well. The idea that ERIP represents is bigger than any one of us, and it is an important idea for this country. So graduates, today marks the day. You have each chosen success. And choosing success is never easy. When you choose to be successful, you risk failure. But you made that choice to be successful many, many days, and each day you lived up to it. And as a result, you're here today, and in a few moments, you're going to walk across that stage. I thought a little bit about as a keynote speaker, as opposed to your CEO, advice would I give you? And I thought, okay, what do I wish someone had told me when I was 18? Now, highly likely at 18, I would not have listened. But if I thought about, I don't want to give you the standard advice of work hard, have integrity, don't give up, persevere. You've heard that. You've heard that through Europe a great number of times. What I want to do is talk to you about a couple things that I really wish I was smart enough to listen to if someone were to tell me when I was 18. And the first one of those, I honestly didn't learn until I was 35 years old. The first one is, how do you live a life of being grateful? Right? How do you get up every day? And I wish someone had told me this when I was 21. How do you get up every day? And before you put your feet on the floor, you look up to whoever you look up to. For me, I say, God, thank you so much. Thank you so much for giving me my health, my children's health, the love of my wife. And you know what? For the last 15 years, I have gone to bed happier at night because you practice gratitude. Right? As Maya Angelou said about being grateful, she said, today is a wonderful day. I've never seen this day before. To have the gratitude as you get up every day, again, I promise you, you will go to bed happier at night if you get that discipline of every single day for saying, I'm grateful for all the good things in my life and start to talk, think about them, and boy, it helps. Second thing I'd ask you to do is once a year, get up real early, look yourself in the mirror before the kids get up, before anyone else gets up, and give yourself grades. In my case, as a father, as a male, I grade myself as a father, a husband, a family member, a friend, and a worker. Worker was only one grade, right? Father, husband, friend, family member, worker. Once a year, do that. Don't BS yourself because it doesn't matter. No one's listening. No one knows even the grades you gave yourself. But just ask yourself each year, do I like my grades? Am I living up to being superior to my former self? Am I being the mother or father, husband or wife, partner? Am I being a good friend? Right? Am I trying hard to be a good family member? Worker is only one of the grades. And yes, I expect you to get an A as a worker, but you cannot get an A as a worker if you are failing yourself in the other grades. So be that honest conversation with yourself. The last thing that I wish someone had taught me a long time ago was the absolute joy of being in a position to serve others and to actually craft out a part of your life which is about public service or service to someone else. It is so deeply important. You know, I'm sitting next to our mayor today, a gentleman who's crafted a life in public service. Well, not everyone is going to be the mayor. But the fact is everyone here, everyone can say, what is my public service role? What is my service role? Am I at the PTA, Parent Teacher Association? Am I helping someone in a senior center to learn new skills? Am I volunteering? But let me tell you, if you can serve another human being, you are healthy yourself. Service is a sign of health, right? Whether it's physical, spiritual, mental, financial health. To be in a position to serve another human being is a grateful act. And so at every age in life, whether you're 10 or 50 or 80, it's asked, what can I do to serve others today? And it may be 10 minutes, it may be an hour, it may be once a week, but to have that as part of your life, I promise you, it'll lead you to be happier and more fulfilled. Right? They say, this is the start of Black History Month, so a few quotes came to mind. Shirley Chisholm said that service is the rent we pay for a room on this earth. Right? Which makes a lot of sense when you hear it. And certainly is one of the most famous quotes about that, Martin Luther King, that everybody can be great because anybody can serve. So those three things I did not know, nor did I understand at the age of 18. And I really wish I incorporated some of those into my life well before I was getting close to middle age. So if I could pass that on to you, that's all I'd want to do from a keynote speech. All right, in just a few minutes, you can walk across the stage. One of the most important obligations that you're going to take is what is your now role after you graduate. And the most important thing I can say to you grads today is you've got to all lift while you climb. It is critical. It is a solemn, important obligation that only you will know, am I doing this? Am I lifting while I'm climbing? The power inherent in that is vast. And I'll tell you, we've served 13,000 young people. Over the next 7 years, we'll have 30,000 graduates. Imagine if every one of those graduates lifted three other people with them by potentially giving them an internship, because you'll be in a position to hire, to help recruit another person to a program like Year Up, if not Year Up, to volunteer. Imagine if 30,000 people do that and they touch three people a year. We're now talking 100,000 people. This starts to get interesting numbers-wise. It starts to look like what Meiji, you said, a strong, important voice. It starts to look like a movement for social and economic justice, which everyone in this room knows we need in this country. I know that you have the power to move this nation, Major, and your colleagues today, and the thousands that have come before and the thousands that will come after you. You have the power to create one of the best 21st century networks this country has ever seen. You have the power to pass on a better generation to your children. And I don't go to bed for 1 second doubting that that is the path you are on as leaders of this movement that are critical for the health and democracy that we love and enjoy every day. So I'm incredibly happy to be here with you as your speaker. I feel safe, peaceful, knowing who we are surrounded by, the graduates today, the future graduates in 6 months' time. We are in good hands. We are grateful to you in the hands you're going to use to hold our communities and make them strong in the years to come. I wish you all the very, very best on your journeys. I thank you all for being here, and I so look forward to clapping for you in just a few moments. Thank you.
Thank you, Gerald, for those kind words and everything that you do for us. Good morning, everyone. My name is Johnny Perez. I am a proud member of Class 21, and today I have the pleasure of presenting to you this year's Outstanding Supervisor Award. First, I would like to ask for all of the supervisors of Class 21 to please stand up to be recognized. Now it is my honor to present to you this year's recipient. Not only has this well-rounded individual served as an amazing supervisor, he has also been an incredible mentor. My supervisor, Tom Klump, has been involved with the Year Up program since 2012. Tom is a senior vice president of technology services at Citizens Bank and has supported 5 Year Up interns before me. He genuinely offers to guide his interns down the right paths for their careers. And recently, he helped significantly grow Europe's internship presence at Citizens Bank. With relation to Europe's mission, Tom has more than played his role in helping to close the opportunity divide. Each day of my internship, Tom has displayed all of the characteristics that constitute a great leader. Through his many years of service to this country, his great communication skills, his positive attitude and ingenuity, he sets an example for everyone around him. His peers at Citizens Bank have never been short of great things to say regarding him as a person and the impeccable work that he stands for. I remember when I first met Tom. He made me feel welcome. He encouraged me to seek out opportunities and to network throughout the company. He made himself available when I needed advice and also when improving my resume. At one point, I expressed to him my interest in continuing my education. And I am now currently taking the last two classes that I need to complete my associate's degree at CCRI. In May, I plan on being at another graduation. Words cannot describe the gratitude that I have for Tom, for his continuous support and his feedback throughout my journey. On a daily basis, Tom has inspired me on both a personal level and a professional level. Through his effort and dedication to his job, he has motivated me to reach my full potential. With all that said, I want to thank Tom here in front of everyone today. Thank you, Tom, for allowing me to grow with your dedicated time and mentorship. Recently, I was hired at Citizens Bank. And I hope that we are colleagues for a very long time to come. It is truly my honor to present the Outstanding Supervisor Award to Tom Klump. Thank you, Tom, and please join me on stage to accept this award.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Before getting into this presentation for this award, I would like to ask all mentors to please stand up in order to be recognized. My name is Jason Santos, and I am honored and beyond grateful to stand on this stage today because I have been granted the opportunity and the privilege to present a special award to someone very special to me. The Director of Global Talent Acquisition, Leo Perron, has been an amazing mentor to me and an even better friend throughout these past few months. You have met with me week after week through thick and thin and constantly checked on me regarding my performance as a finance intern at Providence Equity, as well as my personal life outside of work and school. You constantly motivated me and pushed me to push forward when times got tough. You inspired me to aim higher, to get my name out there, and applied to positions that I thought I wasn't qualified for at the moment. You set me up with an informational interview with the Commissioner of Public Safety of Rhode Island and provided me with great insight about those careers. The night before a big interview with EMC Squared, you met with me for dinner in order to prepare me for the big moment the next morning. And, well, I got the job. You're the man, Leo. And I hope that I can continue to learn from you and continue this relationship in the years to come. I felt very unsure before meeting you at first, but honestly, I could not have asked for a better mentor. Please join me up here to accept this award.
Amy Ullman, Director of Development for Europe, and one of the great things I get to do is make matches like that happen. Before I present our next award, I'd like to just direct your attention to the center of the table. There's a nice postcard there that lists our high five, so five ways to get more connected with Europe, either by hiring one of our graduates, bringing on an intern, volunteering, mentoring, or investing. My email is on the back, so please, I look forward to hearing from all of you. Thanks. So I'm honored to present the Community Impact Award, which recognizes extraordinary commitment and positive impact on Europe and our students. The award is going to Alex Anani Charity by Design, who has been an exceptional partner in all of the aspects I just mentioned. Alex Anani has welcomed Europe interns, and now more than a dozen of their employees serve as mentors and volunteers. They serve as a graduation sponsor and currently employ 8 Europe graduates. About a quarter of their IT department is Europe grads, and growing. So most recently, Alex Anani Charity by Design partnered with Europe to design a new charm called the Knight, symbolizing empowerment, possibility, and intuition. Actually have it on right here. The 3D Knight chess piece was designed to represent the steps that Europe students take as they move through the program, the very deliberate steps to get through and reach positive outcomes. So I'm happy to say that Europe will receive 20% of the purchase price, and more importantly, Europe is now in stores across the country, and more people know about us. Thank you. So joining me on stage today is Christian Moore, a class 19 graduate and one of Alex Anani's newest employees. Some of you may remember Christian from last January's graduation when he delivered an exceptional keynote. So thank you to Alex Anani Charity by Design. Key to our partnership is Nikki Marr, who's Senior Vice President for Charity by Design. Nikki was instrumental not only in starting the partnership, but in growing our partnership. And so as a long-term mentor, she's also one of the best champions for our work that I know. Nikki, thank you. And please join Christian and I on stage to accept the Charity by Design.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Marlon Randahall. I'm the Associate Director of Program here at Europe Providence.
Good morning, and I'm Alicia Hartley, and I'm one of the program managers here, and I'm honored to be able to give our first Outstanding Student Award today. This is a first ever award for Europe Providence, the Colleague Supporter Award. The Europe Colleague Supporter Award recognizes a graduating student chosen by his colleagues who consistently helps others out, no matter the situation or the time that it will take. He consistently puts others' needs first, proving that the success of others in this community as a whole was of the utmost importance. He truly embodies what it means to be a member of the Europe community, and you may have heard his name before about the person who had picked the person up coming from Worcester to take him to his internship. Please join me in congratulating Gene Pina, this year's recipient of the Colleague Supporter Award.
Congratulations, Gene. In every graduating class, there are students who are elected by the Europe team and their colleagues as recipients of one, the Excellence, and two, Leadership Awards. Today's winners hail from each of our learning communities, LC1 and LC2. The Europe Leadership Award recognizes a graduating student who is chosen by their colleagues and who consistently leads by example through their actions, work ethic, and integrity. They display professionalism, a positive attitude, and a desire to help the community reach its goals. They are role models that others follow. Please join me in recognizing and congratulating Major Petaway and Cindy Miranda for their excellence and exceptional leadership.
Last award, but certainly not the least, is the Europe Excellence Award, recognizing a graduating student, chosen by their colleagues who consistently demonstrates exceptional effort, produces work of superlative quality, holds themselves to the highest possible standards of actions and behavior, and challenges themselves to exceed expectations at all times. They are role models that others truly follow. Please join me in congratulating Kanika Nguyen and Sheila Dos Santos for their excellence in the program.
I have the distinct honor of introducing this young lady standing to my right. Please welcome Sheila Dos Santos, our speaker this evening, class speaker.
Good morning. My name is Sheila Dos Santos, and 1 year ago today, I was a new mom working a minimum wage job. And at the age of 23, I could only dream of a future in which I could provide for not only myself, but my family as well. So I stand here today in front of Gerald, mentors, advisors, and Europe supporters, humbled and honored to say thank you for this opportunity. With the help and support of each and every one of you, we will prove statistics wrong. My family came to the United States from the Cape Verdean Islands. My mother is the youngest of 11, and I am the youngest of 5. Having 4 siblings older than me definitely had its perks. I was always getting myself into trouble, and after blaming whatever it was on my siblings, I was always getting myself out of trouble. Growing up, we were not as fortunate as others. However, my mother did everything in her power to make sure we never lacked any necessities. She would wake before the sun came up, worked long hours at a shoelace factory, and despite her schedule, she was always home when we arrived home from school. Raising 5 kids under the age of 5 must have not been easy, but the sacrifices she made for us, the tears she cried for us, never go unnoticed. She is such a phenomenal woman and role model, and for that I owe every fiber of my being to her. So I had no excuse why I couldn't get up and better my life for the one child that I had. After living paycheck to paycheck, I had to change some things. I heard about the ERA program from past graduates, and at first it sounded too good to be true. However, I took the steps, I applied, I got accepted, and the rest is history. Getting up the first day of ERA, leaving my son Dion at 6 months gave me anxiety. I didn't know what ERA had in store for me, but at the end of orientation week, my classmates and I felt a little at ease. The support the staff provided reassured us that this is where we belong and this is where we will become a family. The first half of my year of journey was a roller coaster. I would get up 5 a.m. each day, make sure Dion was set for the babysitter, take 2 buses, and magically get to year up before 8:30 to avoid the infamous infractions. I know many of my colleagues share the same challenges. However, we stood together, and within the next hour, we will cross the finish line together. Hard work, grit, are just a few of the reasons why we stand here today. I personally had some emotional setbacks. On July 6, 2015, I woke up like any regular Monday, and 6:43 a.m., went to go take my dog for a walk. What seemed like a regular Monday changed in a split second. My mom and I were visited by 5 detectives with news that would ruin her life forever. They told my mom to have a seat, and in that instant, my heart dropped. "Ma'am, I'm sorry, but early this morning, your son passed away." And in that brief moment, my life came crashing down. My only brother, my best friend, was claimed as the city's 7th homicide of the year. The night of my brother's passing, I held my son and cried. And as I was rocking him to sleep, I pictured my mom rocking my brother to sleep. I stand here less than 1 mile from where his life was taken, hurt and still in disbelief. Making funeral arrangements made me sick to my stomach. My brother passed away in an ugly way. However, his service was so beautiful. Days after he passed, I had a dream. In a way, I felt as if my brother was trying to communicate with me. Till this day, I have yet to tell my mother about this dream. So this is going to be the first time she is hearing of it. In my dream, my brother was dressed in all white like the angel he is. And he said, "Tell mommy I'm okay." "Tell mommy I will always be in her heart. Tell her when she sees a child playing and her heart feels a little tug, that's me giving her a hug. From that day on, I knew I was never going to be okay, but that I'll be content. I knew I had a reason to continue to strive and to make myself a better person for my son. Somehow, I had to keep pushing. At this moment, I would like to take the time to recognize Providence Mayor Jorge Elorza, because last November, he signed an executive order forming an advisory council aimed at reducing gun violence throughout the city. Thank you, Mayor. Just as my family was trying to heal from the loss of my brother, we received devastating news that my grandma got admitted to the hospital and only had a few days to live. The creator of my family was survived by 11 children, 50 grandchildren, and 61 great-grandchildren. And on Wednesday, December 30th, a few weeks before my internship ended, I held her hand and watched her peacefully take her last breath. The question is, how do I move on? How do I get up each day and live my life as if everything is okay? The answer, it's never gonna be okay. However, with the help and support from friends and family and the amazing staff at Europe, I knew I was gonna heal slowly, but well. Shortly after I lost my brother, I started my 6-month internship at Care New England in the Human Resource Department at Women and Infants. Europe found the perfect family for me. My team at Care New England lifted me while I was down, seeing me for not only just an intern, but a part of their team. I had the privilege of working closely with Vice President Paul Heffernan and Director of Employment Services, Crystal Francis. And boy, let me tell you, at first it was very intimidating. I felt as if I needed to do everything right and have no flaws. Kathy always told me, "Sheila, people like you for you. So just be you," and that's exactly what I did. Throughout this internship, I have gained experience and knowledge that I will take with me throughout my professional career. Thank you, Care New England. And I'm proud to say I just accepted a position at Neighborhood Health Plan, and I will be started on Monday. Class 22, you got this. A few months ago, I was sitting in your seat watching class 20's graduation, and I couldn't wait until my class got the chance to shine. One piece of advice I want to give is to soak up every moment of this experience. Europe's mission is to close the opportunity divide, and each and every one of us can help achieve that. Statistics show, after completing the Europe program, 85% of graduates are employed and are attending college. I am here to pass the torch to you. Let nothing set you back. Class 21, we made it. I know you all have your own story for making it here today. Continue to achieve your dreams. They are all possible. For every employer here today looking for entry level, motivating talent, my story is just one of 64 of my graduating class. I'd like to end my speech with some thank yous. Thank you to my mentor, Sandra Powell, for the knowledge and wisdom you have imparted upon me. To my advisor, Kathy Doyle, I want to express my deepest gratitude for believing in me and inspiring me to pursue my goals. Finally, to my brother, John Dos Santos, and my grandmother, Balbina Mendez, everything I continue to do from here on out, I will do for you. Your memory will forever live on. Thank you. At this time, I am honored to introduce our next guest speaker, Mayor Jorge Elorza.
Good morning, everyone. I absolutely have the toughest job. Following Sheila with such inspirational words, I'd like to begin by just saying thank you to Sheila. Sheila, that speech was amazing, and especially so because it was from the heart, and it reminds us why we do what we do. And we know that an investment in Europe is an investment in real lives, and that these lives are going to continue to change the world. So thank you, Sheila. I'd also like to recognize, you know, a number of guests that we have in the room, colleagues in government and leadership in the organization. I'd like to recognize Secretary of State Nelly Gorbea, General Treasurer Seth Magaziner, Mayor of Central Falls James Diosa, Providence Councilwoman Sabina Matos, Central Falls Councilwoman Stephanie Gonzalez. Thank you also, Gerald, for your inspirational keynote speech and for giving birth to this movement. Thank you to Kathy Doyle for being such a strong leader for this great organization. And I ask everyone in the room to please join me in giving a strong round of applause also for the former executive director and new president of CCRI, Megan Hughes. Megan, you've already changed so many lives, and I look forward to working with you in partnership to see how we can work together to change and impact more. I'd like to once again say congratulations to Sheila Dos Santos. And I'd also like to take a moment to recognize my mentee in Europe, Major Petaway. I had the great honor to become Major Petaway's mentor when I randomly ran into him at an event. And he told me that he was involved in the Europe program. And you know, I've always thought so highly about this program, so I was, you know, instantly very taken. And he just asked me that during that meeting. He said, "Mayor, will you be my mentor?" So something struck me about that, and I said, "Absolutely." You know, it's not easy for a young person to come across the mayor of the city at a social function, engage the mayor in a conversation, and then ask them to make a personal commitment to them. And what I learned from that very first conversation was that Major is a great leader. Major is a great leader who's not afraid to take risks and who's willing to push himself. And over the past year, I've gotten to know, you know, a young man who I've come to admire and in a lot of ways has come to inspire me. So, Major, I want to say congratulations. It's been great serving in this capacity over this past year. I look forward to seeing your continued growth, and I look forward to being this mentor and a good friend to you as you continue to grow. Thank you. So I'd like to begin by talking a little bit about Europe. Now, you know, I was never a part of Europe. Europe didn't exist when I was in college. But I do have to admit that I do feel a connection to Europe and to Europe graduates. You see, my story, I believe, is very similar to the story of so many Europe students. When I graduated from high school, I barely skated by. And when I graduated, I got rejected from every single college that I applied to. So I was at a crossroads in my life, not knowing exactly what my next move or what my future would look like. And I'm standing here today because I had programs such as the EOC program at CCRI and the talent development program at the University of Rhode Island. (Clears throat) I'm standing here because I had programs that believed in me more than I believed in myself at that stage of my life. And I think that that's the case, and that's true for so many Europe students. You know, we see plain as day when we hear from Europe students that they have all the potential in the world. But sometimes, when you're not connected to those opportunities, even if you believe in yourself, it's hard to really see that bridge, see that connection between that God-given talent that you have and that potential that you can reach in the outside world. And that's exactly what Europe does. It's that bridge, it's that connection, and it's that inspiration that makes us each believe that we can one day be great. And so I feel this connection to Europe, and I'm so proud to be a strong, strong supporter. But I also want to say thank you to every single person in this room, because if there's one thing that we've learned from this example of Europe, is that every single one of us has a role to play. Whether we're employers, whether we're mentors, whether we're administrators, we're parents, whether we're students, brothers or sisters, whatever it might be, we all have a role to play in opening doors and opening opportunities. And I just want to be clear in terms of opening doors and opening opportunities. You know, many of us, all we're asking for, we're not even asking for the door to be opened wide open. All we need is a little crack. Just crack that door open for us, and we will show the talent and the potential that we have, and we'll take it the rest of the way. And I do believe that that's what every single one of the Year-Up graduates has done and are prepared to do. So to each one of the Year-Up graduates, as you prepare to go off to your jobs, to university, or to other opportunities, I'd like to share with you just a couple of words of advice. Something that I've learned in my life is that sometimes we limit ourselves. Perhaps not purposefully, we don't know why, but we think perhaps we can reach this goal. I had a conversation with Major a while ago, and it came up that perhaps at some day in the future, some point in the future, Major might be interested in going into politics. And I mean this in full sincerity. If Major or any other graduate, if you're thinking that one day you can become mayor of the city of Providence, I tell you, don't set your sights so low. And I truly mean that. The talent and the capacity that each one of you have here in this room, there is no limit to it. But to realize that capacity, you have to dare to dream, and you can't be afraid to fail. It's often said that success is based upon experience, and experience is based upon failure. And so you have to learn, and you have to continue to push yourself beyond your comfort zone, because if you show me someone who has never slipped, who has never failed, I'll show you someone who has never pushed themselves beyond that comfort zone and hasn't realized their true potential. So push yourself beyond that comfort zone, and as you do, I have no doubt that you're going to go off and become great leaders here in Providence, here in the state, and throughout society. But as you go off, I also want you to remember, I want you to remember where you come from. Just know that you are here because of your talent and your determination. But the truth is that no one does it alone. Everyone in this room is here because there are folks who have come before us, who have believed in us, who have invested in us. And to the Year-Up graduates, you will soon, sooner than you might imagine, find yourself in a position where you can open those doors for the next generation. And the continued success of programs such as these, the success of you as individuals, and the progress of us as a community will depend on whether you're continuing to open those doors behind you and leave them open just as you have walked through them. So dare to believe, dare to be great, don't forget where you come from. To the class of, well, to the 21st year up graduating class, I want you to know that I am proud of you, your city is proud of you, your family is proud of you, the year up community is proud of you. Now go out and change the world. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Mayor, for your inspiring words, but personally, I want to thank you for the first time being the buffer between me and the student speaker, giving me time to recover, stop crying. I appreciate those words are meaningful. Gerald, your words, as always, incredible. My name is Ted Fisher, and I'm honored and humbled to be here as the chair of the Board of Europe Providence. So my first thank you, very quickly, is to my fellow board members, who I'd like to ask to come up and join me to the left of the stage here, my left, so we can all adequately show our appreciation for Class 21. This is a group of the most dedicated, amazingly passionate, talented folks that I have the honor of working with in partnership to serve this community, to really not just try and, you know, get rid of the opportunity of I, but attack it. And I can't thank you enough for allowing me to be part of this group. Gerald, your leadership, your incredible vision has created something that many of us can't describe easily, but being part of it is certainly one of the greatest parts of my life, so thank you for that. I'd also like to just quickly mention our new CCRI president, Megan Hughes, and former executive director of Europe. I really just want to congratulate your priorities, because it's your second day of work and your Europe graduation. I think that's pretty special. And they do not get nearly as much credit as they deserve, but the team at Europe is the most amazing, organizationally focused, committed, dedicated, passionate team I've ever seen. They live every minute of every day, not just working hours, every minute of every day in service of the young adults that we work with and are honored to be with every single day. So Kathy and the team, huge round of applause, please. So, before we asked our graduates to come across the stage, Amy stood up here earlier and talked about this card, which in my talking points say, Ted, talk about the card, so I'm gonna talk about it anyway. And this card actually is not just something to read, but it's actually an active participation device. You can actually check off areas of interest, put your name on here, and leave it on the table, and someone will pick it up and we'll be in contact with you. But we saw some great awards tonight, Supervisor Award, the Mentor Award. I say this often, but my greatest honor being part of Europe is being a mentor. And if any of you were at our event a month or so ago in Providence, I had had a long day. I'd flown in from Vegas and I read a text that I got about midway through the day from my Class 22 mentee, Regine. And it's the kind of text that you'd want to get about somebody who is progressing, finding their way, and living the life that they want to live, and doing it in a way that Europe has made possible. But yesterday, I received a text from Alberto, who is my mentee from Class 18, just to show you, I always say that Europe is a life sentence, so we're all here for the long term. But it says, hey Ted, how are you? I have great news. I've been promoted at work, and I'm super excited. I'm moving out of my engineering support role into a small business engineer where I will have my own clients. Also, wedding plans are underway. Our date is June 10th. Keep an eye out for the invitation. I want you and your family to share in our great day. So, yeah. Getting involved with Year Up is something that has changed my life profoundly, and I encourage all of you to find your way into it as well. And with that, I will bring up George Nipo and team to do what Class 21 has been waiting for about a year. Thank you.
Thanks, Ted, and good morning, everybody. My name is George Nipo. I'm the Senior Director of Program and Academics at Year Up Providence, and on behalf of the entire Year Up team, it's now my honor to congratulate all of Class 21 on everything that they've done. Give it up for them real quick. In addition to their Year Up diplomas, they'll also be receiving citations from Governor Raimundo, Senators Reid and Whitehouse, Congressman Cicilline and Langevin, Attorney General Kilmartin, and Providence Mayor Jorge Elorza. So without further ado, I say we get this going, and I'd like for Isha Abreu to join me on stage as the first graduate of Class 21. Larissa Angeles. Emmanuel Ancoma. Johanny Baez. Samira Bernal Damasco. Maddie Rose Bonilla. Robert Braxton. Corey Bullock. Jose Cardona. Joseph Castro. Barack Chung. Daniel Cordero. David Custodio. Selimar De Barros. Vicky Disla. Victor Disla. Sheila Dos Santos. Clarence Early. Estefany Escobar. Debbie Franco. Lowry Garcia. Shirley Gaitan. Catherine Godoy. Adalgisa Guzman Fanini. Elizabeth Hernandez. Evelyn Ibanez. Scotty Intapon. Alexander LeBron. Thomas Martinez. Jorge Mejia. Lisette Mejia Quiñones. Luis Mejias. Cecilia Mercado. Cindy Miranda. Valentina Molina. Erendita Montes. Julio Navas. Kanika Nguyen. Michelle Nicolasi. Sylvia Nimaha. Vanak U. Angela Oof. Johnny Perez. Anasia Peralt. Caitlin Peters. Major Petaway. Sapan Fay. Downvasal Pitch. Jean Pina. Roslyn Ramirez. Ariana Rivera. Ulysses Rivera. Luis Rodriguez. Miguel Rodriguez. Juseli Rodriguez. Ivan Ruiz. Julie Salas. Jason Santos Gill. Malia Saar. Kevin Sun. Juliet Tamayo. Aris Tavares. Jonathan Tercera. And Pencherad Tatch. Ladies and gentlemen,